She's not what you'd expect. She's tough and feisty, but gentle and tender. She makes millions and gives millions to the poor. She cries, she laughs, she teaches, she comforts. This is the Dani Johnson Show.
Welcome to the Dani Johnson Show. Hey, do you know any overreactors? You know, kind of like they're a bomb. You know what I'm saying? It's like, I don't know, you know, something happens that's like a two, right? It's a two offense and they have a 10 response where they're just like, wah! Kind of like manifesting like a principality of darkness. Hi, I'm Dani Johnson. This is the Dani Johnson Show. We're here every single day, actually 6 days a week. You can find the Dani Johnson Show radio and television. And this is the show where we talk about important topics that will help to improve every area of your life, your financial life, your business, your career, your marriage, and your parenting, whether you have toddlers driving you crazy or your teenagers are driving you nuts. And I've come into this new place of adult children. Oh my gosh. Somebody needs to tell me how to deal with them. Somebody needs to tell me how to deal with them. Actually, I'm talking to some people about how to deal with them. Anyway, so this is that show where you and I get to have a discussion 6 days a week concerning your life and how together we can make it better. And I'm not talking about together as in you and me. I'm talking about all of us. Man, if this is your first time joining us on the show, you will be so very blessed by our callers, our faithful listeners to the Dani Johnson Show that always bring this crazy contribution to every single program that we do. So I hope that if it is your first time, you are thoroughly blessed by what we talk about today, because today is an important one. I don't know if you've noticed, but we live in a really hostile society. People like give dirty looks and freak out. There I was, okay, at the Los Angeles International Airport. And I'm so blessed that I took my girlfriend's advice and I got there really early. Okay, my flight wasn't until 2:45. We were in Long Beach, gonna fly out of LAX, right? And she said, you know what, there might be traffic. I would recommend that you don't leave at 1, but you leave at noon. It took us an hour to get our bag checked and it took 30 minutes to get through security. So you might wanna give yourself, you know, at least 2 hours, at the airport, and give yourself an extra 45-minute buffer in case there's traffic. I'm so glad I listened to her, because sure enough, oh my, were there some stressed out, freaking out wild crackers at the LAX airport, and the line was all the way on the street outside, backed up for it seemed like a mile, but it wasn't. Anyway, so here, check it. So here's the Southwest help lady who's directing traffic. And I'm telling you, she was a beautiful woman. She was absolutely gorgeous with her gorgeous dreads and oy, her beautiful lips. But I'm telling you, some ugliness came out of her eyeballs. I mean, I had a little shiver go up my spine. I felt like I was a little kid being given a dirty look by my mama. But she wasn't giving the dirty look. She was giving it to somebody else. You know, she you can understand. She had to say the same thing over and over again. The line starts there. And somebody's trying to talk to her. And she just got her eyes all big. The line is over there. Lady, this guy just came up to you. He didn't hear you say it the 25,000 other times that you'd been saying it already for the last 4 hours. Because he wasn't there. But we do. We live in these really crazy times where people are so stressed out and they don't have really the best, I don't know, couth, if you will. They don't have the, you know, they just don't have a lot of patience today. But I think it might be important for you and I maybe to look in the mirror on this one and see, am I one of those overreactors? I was, right? Something would happen. And I'm telling you, I would let out the drama queen. Yep, I would release her. Kind of like the Kraken in Pirates of the Caribbean. Did you just see that? Okay, do you know what I mean? Did you get the picture in your head? Here's the Kraken. Release the Kraken, you know? And here it comes, this octopus, whatever, giant monster from the bottom of the sea that comes up and just surrounds all of the Black Pearl ship and just takes it down. That's what I would do whenever something would happen. Like what? Oh, someone not showing up that said they were going to be there. Oh, you know, my world was just destroyed because they said they were going to be there and then they didn't show up. And then that means that this isn't going to happen. And that this is ruined. That means I'm not going to meet this deadline. And oh no, what am I going to do about my MasterCard payment? I would just completely freak out. But I didn't know I was freaking out, friend. I didn't know it. In fact, I didn't realize what such an overreactor I was back then until recent years. I'm going to tell you what reminded me. I would have several people tell me, especially this millionaire that I was learning from. He says, Dani, you know what your problem is? No, sir. What do you think it is? I have a lot of problems, but what do you think my problem is? He goes, dude, act instead of react. You're really hot-headed. Act instead of react. Okay. And I really thought he was kind of lame for saying that, honestly. And then the other part of me was like, he doesn't know what he's talking. He doesn't live with me. How does he know that I react? So there I was reacting. And then once I finished being mad about it, then my emotions would go, you know, I'd totally be depressed about it. Like, I'm a total loser. I overreact. And even he sees that I overreact. No joke. So then it's like silence. Then I'm not going to say anything. Isn't that pathetic? From, he doesn't know what he's talking about. He doesn't live with me. He doesn't know. I was totally reacting right there. And then silence. Then I will not say anything ever. So immature. But man, I had several people tell me that in my very early years of business, and I did not know why they all kept saying that. But man, I'm telling you, it was the truth. Such a drama queen. Yeah, like hardcore. I probably still am in all reality, right? And maybe I don't know how much of an overreactor I am. But here's something I want to know about you. Have you ever had a 10 reaction for a 2 offense that somebody else did? What do you feel actually causes you to act or react in situations that don't go your way? What is your MO? What is your method of operation when things don't go your way? Do you act like a 2-year-old that their 3-year-old brother just took a toy away from him? Right? Freak out, scream. Stomp, hit in your own little way, whether it's verbal or physical or whatever. But what is your standard method of operation that you respond in when things don't go your way? Are you a recovering drama king or queen? Because there is both. Oh, yes. I've lived with some. I've worked with some. We all have. So which one are you? And what did you do to stop overreacting? I can't tell you how timely this show is. We just came from a training seminar called First Steps to Success, just like the one that we're doing. You need to check out the website and find the next dates for First Steps to Success. And this seminar actually teaches you how to annihilate all of your debt in 5 to 7 years and gives you a little more peace, less stress, how to build a business, or if you work for someone else, how do you grow in that career and dominate the job market? All doing this, having more fun and more family time, okay? So anyway, that's what First Steps to Success is. But here at our last one, it was really amazing because we have somebody on our team that does video at home in our corporate office. And he was on the traveling team and he did audio on that traveling team. And one of the things that we admire the most, his name is Jonathan. The thing that we admire most about Jonathan is that he has a cool head. He's very cool headed. And that actually has very high value in this particular setting, in the setting of the craziness of a seminar, right? We have hundreds and hundreds of people, sometimes 1,000 or 1,100 or 1,200 or 1,300 people like we did in San Antonio. That's a lot of people with a lot of demands, a lot of requests, a lot of whatevers. They feel like they need to be served and you should serve me now and the way I want to be served. For some reason, they think they're going through a Burger King drive-through and they want their Whopper their way. And that is honestly how people first come when they come to First Steps. By the time we're done with them, they don't quite have the same attitude. But anyway. But we need people with a cool head in that kind of an environment, right? Because there's all kinds of hotheads all over the place, right? Not to mention, right, you know, the internet line isn't working. You know, the hotel staff, they stink sometimes. You know, somebody gets sick. You know, the AV equipment isn't working right. There's so many different things that can go wrong in putting on a large event like that. And so Jonathan is somebody that we all grew to appreciate so much because he has a cool head. And we asked him the question, Jonathan, how do you have a cool head like that? Like, how did you learn how to do that? And he said that his dad really drilled it in him when he was young and that he used to be a major hothead when he was younger. And that one of his techniques that he uses is to just take a deep breath and to think of a bigger picture, that there's a big picture here. It's not just this one little component that just decided not to work. It is just one component in a big, larger picture. But to think in terms of the big picture and to always know, and he didn't use these words, but I'll use these words, don't sweat the small stuff. It's all small stuff. And so, are you a hothead or a cool head? I'll tell you what, being a cool head has a lot of value in the workplace and at home. You know, I grew up with hot-headed parents. And when you grow up with hot-headed parents, you think that everyone's always mad at you. You think that you're always in trouble. You could just feel the tension in the air and you just know that the rubber band's about to snap and someone's head is gonna roll due to my father's intense hot-headedness, and that's the man that raised me, not my biological father. So let's talk about this. So if you're one, I want to know what your advice is if you're one of those cool-headed people, and or if you once were a hothead and you were an overreactor, please, and you've done better, meaning you've made progress in the right direction, please tell us how you've done it. The phone number is 844-200-3264. Again, that's 844-200-3264. You know, it once was said, you know, as you get older, you know, you just get wiser. I just haven't found that to be true in a lot of cases. No, not at all have I found that to be true. I'm seeing older people overreacting. I'm seeing young people overreacting. A lot of people acting like two-year-olds these days. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue with more and your call right after this.
Do you dream about feeling more confident, more beautiful, more powerful, but instead you're that girl that never learned to do their makeup and now you feel lost in a sea of YouTube makeup tutorials? Or you're that new mom that can't get enough sleep at night and just wants to feel pretty again? Or the busy professional that wants to magnetize brand new clients and get more respect in the office? From the boardroom to the bedroom, XMHbeauty.com will help you. Our company has a proven track record of making beauty available on any budget, from celebrities to girls just like you and me. Our live classes, step-by-step tutorials, and insider secrets will have you standing out from the crowd. Go to xmhbeauty.com/Dani today to get your free gift from us. That's xmhbeauty.com/D-A-N-I.
Imagine living in a decrepit, unsafe hovel made of waste material on top of old mining tunnels that could explode and sink your home at any moment. Imagine no water to drink, no safe place to raise your children, no food for your starving baby. Imagine that your kids can't learn to read because they have to work to support the family instead of going to school. Could you imagine living in that kind of fear and hopelessness? This is exactly what families are dealing with in the poverty-stricken village of Santa Pancha, Nicaragua. These families can barely meet their basic food, water, and housing needs. We are transforming that village. Be a part of this miracle. I want you to go to the website now and learn how you can help. Go to kingsransom.org and click on Santa Pancha. There you can join with other warriors against poverty and help bring a miraculous transformation to Santa Pancha. That's kingsransom.org, kingsransom.org.
Now, more of the Dani Johnson Show.
Have you had someone blow up at you recently? Oh, man, I've seen people blowing up at people at airports, in hotels, thinks. It's really quite shocking, isn't it? I don't know. It's almost as though, I could totally be wrong on this deal, but it's almost as though we are living in a world of people that are maturity levels around 12. Yeah. And we have to dig into why is it that people are so overreacting? It's like time bombs walking around all over the place in the kids, in the adolescents, in the 20-year-olds, in our 30-year-olds, in the 50, in the 70, and 80-year-olds, man. It's like, wow, where is people's peace? I don't know what the word is that I'm looking for. Couth keeps coming to me, but I'm not quite sure if that's the word. Maybe I should have finished high school. I did. Anyway, maybe I should have went to college, but I didn't. But yeah, you know, it's that, I don't know, the cool-headed, I'm not saying cool like you're so cool. I'm saying like, chillax, man, chillax. Don't sweat the small stuff. It's all small stuff. Dignity, I think, is the word I'm looking for, actually. Yeah, where's people's dignity today? Where's their self-respect? Have you noticed people are, like, really hostile? 844-200-3264. Have you had someone bite your head off? How did it make you feel? Or did you bite people's head off? Are you an overreactor, drama king or queen? How are you going to fix this? You need help with this? Maybe. I don't know. I don't know if I can help you. But I do know this. Together as a team with this show, with everybody that's involved on this show, I think we might be able to come up with some solutions. We've got a call from the United Kingdom, the UK. We got Bronwyn. Welcome to the Dani Johnson Show.
Right, that's me.
Hi, Bronwyn. What can I do for you?
Hi, how are you doing, Dani?
Very good to hear your beautiful accent that I love.
Oh, bless you. I'm in Wales, actually, in nice. United Kingdom.
Nice. All right, so are you a drama king, queen, overreactor, or are you one of them cool-headed people?
I'm a drama queen with my husband, and I'm cool with my clients.
Oh!
I've got this dual personality going on.
Oh, Bronwyn, I'm so proud of you that you are transparent and honest.
Yeah.
Dani, I love to treat my clients better than I treat my husband.
Yeah. Oh, that hurts, but it's true.
Yeah. Bronwyn.
It's true. It really is.
Your priorities are out of whack.
Mm-hmm.
Your husband's not your priority in your life because you have more self-control with professional relationships than you do with your spouse, which means you possess self-control, right?
Absolutely.
You do?
Absolutely. I believe it's just a habit. It's a habit I've got into that I can get out of, but
yes.
I need to act and not react. We work together. We work in our small business together. So we are daily with each other, and it needs to change.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so let me just tell you, because I understand. I've been there, done that. And really, when it all boils down to this, is that my priority of people was wrong. And that, you know, your clients upset you, right? They lie, they cheat, they steal.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
Right? They hurt your feelings. They don't follow through with what they said they're going to do, right? I mean, they do all the same thing your husband does.
But
look at our double standard, right? Oh, so we bring the love of the Lord to our clients, but we bring the demonic principality of hell against our husband.
Yeah.
And this is wrong. This is straight out wrong. So here's my recommendation. Yeah. You do whatever you want. Repent.
Yeah. Yeah.
Turn. Turn. Your husband has to be the higher priority. And so, okay, now hold on a second, because we already have to go to a break. But I got to tell you this, because I am holding on for your dear life, my sister, on this message myself, so much so that I have it on my body now. Okay, I don't know if you watched the spiritual equipping that we did from San Antonio, but it might be a message you want to watch again and again and again, and you would want to print out the passages in which I taught on and have it posted where you work with your husband, in your bathroom, wherever you first see first thing in the morning, I would do this, because this is something that God challenged me to do, and you could throw this away or not, but I'm telling you, it changes my attitude in an instant. And it's on our website. If you are an insider, you know, it's included in your insider membership, which is so cheap. It's a $5 a month or something stupid like that. But you got to see this. It is so powerful. I cried through this message. I couldn't get through this message without weeping. When I received the message, I wept. This message so kicked me in the butt that I have it now plastered in places where I have to see it every single day, even when I'm traveling, if you can connect some dots. So hold the line, Brownon, because I want to give you some more insight on that. Okay. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue with more after this.
You're listening to The Dani Johnson Show. Stay tuned for more of Dani Johnson in just a moment.
We own our own business, and we were working like crazy. We have actually three kids and one on the way right now. And for me, I was working like all the time. In fact, for the last 10 years, I've been working probably close to 80 hours a week, and no time with the family. Just totally, really, actually, you know, it was pretty awful. In fact, we were really struggling with the family dynamic, and the business wasn't growing. Just felt like it just wasn't gonna happen.
Previous to having kids, I had helped with the business, but then after we started having kids, with each child, kind of had backed out from that more, and then really just had kind of grown to resent a lot of what was going on in the business, because I just felt like it was competition for me and for my family, for my kids. I just felt like we had to constantly be competing with his work. We just felt really stuck in all aspects of life. And once he started really plugging in and I started plugging in, the main difference that I saw was just his priorities really started changing. Like, I had never really even seen him try to implement time management, really. You know, I mean, it was always just like, this is what I have to do, this is business, this is how we do it here. Our communication skills just started being so much more open between us just from spending that little bit of time together. Because he hadn't been devoting any specific time to me, literally. I was not on the calendar, I mean, we had time together, but I didn't feel honored or prioritized, or I didn't feel like anything was specifically for me. So that just like totally changed my view of him and just me wanting to support him. Just that one thing was a huge thing for me, just him putting me on his calendar. And it immediately changed the stress level in our home, because there wasn't competition. You know, I didn't feel like I was having to compete for his time. Immediately, I just felt like so much more. I had a whole different level of respect for him. Seriously, like, it was like an immediate change.
From a business perspective, after plugging into First Steps and Dynasty, we actually cut my hours back. I cut my hours back to no more than 40 hours a week. Cutting my hours back to 40 was kind of stressful, but I cut it back and I found that I actually became more productive. And our business, within a year, we actually raised up three new six-figure income earners within our team, which just feels awesome. Our income has exploded, and we have more free time to spend with Heather and the babies, and it's been amazing.
Yeah.
How much have we paid off?
We paid off $95,000 debt in 24 months. That'll be great!
This is your chance. This is your shot. Get your copy of War on Debt right now. There's one waiting for you that has your family's name on it. And inside that package is freedom, your family's freedom. It's on the inside of that package. All you have to do is open it up, press play, and start applying what I teach you in this program. 888-757-8880. You and I are going to help your family become completely debt-free in the next 5 to 7 years. Just imagine how that's going to feel.
Giving you the playbook to design your life. This is The Dani Johnson Show. And now, here's Dani.
Do you find yourself that it's easier to treat people that you work with better than those that you live with? I'll tell you what, there is a book that's rocking my insides right now. And it's a book that I never imagined in a million years that I would ever read, and I don't generally read a lot of books like this at all, ever, actually. These kind of books usually bore me, but it's It's by Dr. Laura Schlesinger. All right, I got it yesterday. It's in my little iPad, and I got it off of Amazon. And it's The Proper Care and Feeding of Husbands. And, you know, I thought, I wonder what this is about. And, you know, it's all based off of her show, which is a very, very successful show still to this day, even though, you know, she was at the height of her career many years ago. But she's a very, very powerful communicator and very wise. And everything she teaches is biblically based as well. But anyway, yeah, I'm getting rocked in this book. I really am. And I had no idea how much Dr. Laura and I had similar views and takes on things and how we work with people. This little book is rocking my world. I recommend it. So anyway, we just had Brandon call in from the UK right before our last break. And she was talking about how with her clients, she has all the patience in the world for them, but for her husband, she's a drama queen and she overreacts on things that he says and does. So the first thing I said was, it shows that your priorities are out of whack, that you give better care and feeding to your clients than you do your own husband. There's a big problem here. And that means that he's a lower priority than her clients. And these two work together. The husband and wife work together. And that's a very challenging. My husband and I worked together for 23 years. It's a very difficult, very challenging, especially when you are a strong wife. You have a strong personality as a wife and you've got vision and all of this stuff. It's very challenging, both for the husband and for the wife, to keep the priorities in the relationship, meaning to keep the highest priority each other in that business realm. When we don't see eye to eye, we don't agree something about finances, we don't agree about the direction of a company or whatever, it's very challenging to work in that kind of environment. But it can be done. It comes at a very high price, but it can be done. So joining me now from the United Kingdom is Brownon. And we are talking further about the situation with her husband. Okay, so Brownon, this is what I would recommend. I said earlier, repent, yeah. Right? Your husband needs to get higher up on the priority. But this is what God, this is what God said to me. And this was in Nicaragua. Yeah. And he and I got into a tizzy, more like a tornado. But fortunately, we were in public, so it couldn't be a full-blown tornado. But we got in a tizzy. So our voices were very low. But I know exactly what my eyes were saying. Anyway, long and the short of it was this, is that the Lord challenged me. And he said, I want you to love Hans the way you love me. And I'm telling you, what? Oh, really? You want me to love my husband the way I love you? So I literally began to picture Hans as Jesus. I would want to be around him 24/7 now, wouldn't I? Yeah.
Yeah.
What kind of honor and respect do I give my Lord that I don't give my husband? He also said to forgive Hans for this little tizzy. I mean, it was over something stupid. It was something that he found out first about and he didn't tell me, and he let someone else tell me in a text. It was a big, like, life change, discussion, and he let a kid tell me through text. Really?
Yeah.
So I was mad. I'll just say that. I was mad. And I was in the country of my bloodline, Nicaragua. So I think it boiled a little more than normal, maybe. Right? The Nicaraguan girl in Nicaragua. Anyway, so the long of it is, he said this, forgive Hans how I have forgiven you. Wow. And just as you were just saying, you can forgive your clients for all the stupid things they do.
Yeah.
But you build a case against your husband on the mistakes that he makes.
Yeah.
That's a plan of disaster. And you made vows with this man, and you love him. Brown, you sleep with him.
Yeah.
You sleep with him.
That's right.
He sees you naked.
Yeah.
How much more should we be forgiving of our husband and our kids in which we live with and extend even more grace and more mercy than strangers?
Yeah.
So, That's the deal, girlfriend. You got to switch your priorities.
It is.
God showed me that I had people ahead of my husband, as I could be so much more gracious even to some people on my staff, and even more forgiving, and I don't keep a record of wrong. And you know what my attitude is with our staff? When they screw up, and I'm telling you, like, I had one staff member screw up to the tune of $100,000. Did I blow up in her face?
Whoa.
Nope. Did I freak out, distrust her now forever? No. It was, you know what? We've all made big financial mistakes. We'll bounce back. Mm-hmm. We'll be okay.
Yeah.
The first time my husband lost $100,000, I wasn't that nice. And that was wrong. Mm. That I could have somebody screw up to the tune of $100,000, and I was gracious and compassionate, and I felt her pain and her shame and her guilt. But here, my husband can make the same exact mistake, and I'm like, what? That was like 10 years ago, but that's, you know what I'm saying. That I would overreact to him, but have so much more grace for a coworker. Mm-hmm. This is wrong. This means that the spouse is not in the right position. My life is out of order.
No, you're right.
Yep. So that would be my recommendation, love.
Okay.
It's time to repent. It's time to say sorry to your husband. He knows that he's not high up on your priority list. He feels it. He absolutely feels it.
Yeah.
Love him. Take care of him, honor him, and give him lots of sex. Look at her. That's the last thing in the world I want to do. I would go do that now. And after you're done.
Oh,
awesome. After you're done, you say, honey, will you please forgive me for being such a female dog?
That's right.
Yeah. And this is just an offering to show you how grateful I am that you will forgive me for being so rude and mean to you. It's been wrong.
Yeah.
That's the beginning of change, girl. You could try to change your habits, but I'm telling you, unless you confess, unless you make it right, and unless you give him even permission to call you out with kindness whenever you start doing it again, nothing's going to change. You need the accountability. You need to fess up, and you need to do it right. I'm so excited for you.
Thank you so much.
This just changed your whole world, and it really changed your husband's.
It has. It's rocked my world. It has.
Yeah, that's awesome. Thanks so much for being a listener on the Dani Johnson Show. I so appreciate you. Man, I appreciate you. How awesome is that? Okay, we've got Jessica from South Boston, Virginia. South Boston, Virginia. That's amazing.
Hi, Dani.
Hi.
Hey, I was calling because of a problem that I recently had at work. Well, it's been an ongoing problem. I have a new job, and I've had it 4 or 5 months. And my boss, honestly, he's just been a real total jerk to me. I don't know how else to say it, but I know that's an awful thing to say about your boss. And I normally am not the type of person that would ever say that about a boss, because I've always been the type that was, you know, if I saw somebody being disrespectful to a boss or any figure of authority, I'll be like, you know what, they're your boss, you might not agree with them, but you gotta respect them. Do you want to keep your job? You
that's
know
right.
That type of attitude.
That's good, Jessica.
So I've always been the type to not like it when I saw people doing that. And even if I had to, I would bite my tongue.
Oh, but hold on 1 second, Jessica. Hold on 1 second here. So it sounds to me that you have maybe encountered some kind of treatment that others have received in other places in their life, and now you get to walk through it and feel
right.
it when the boss is a jerk to you.
He is. I'll walk into the office, and I'll ask him a question for a customer, and he's like, get out of my office. I mean, sometimes he'll yell, and the customers can hear him. And I'm like, you know what? That's not good customer service. I'll walk out of there, and I'll literally say out loud in front of everybody, he is such a jerk. Like, how can he say that to me? I'm asking a question for a customer. What is his problem? And he'll say stuff like, I've never felt like hitting a woman, but I feel like hitting you. And I'm like, you know what? I mean, obviously, me asking him questions.
Okay. Hold on. We got to cut to a break. I don't want to miss any part of this story. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue right after this.
Hey, have you done a favor for your best friend yet? Then do it now. Share this program with them. The Dani Johnson Show, helping people just like you make life more enjoyable and rewarding. The Dani Johnson Show.
Hi, I'm Dani Johnson. The most common question I get usually are from people who are trying to juggle their life. They've got kids. They've got kids who are involved in all kinds of activities. They've got business or their job, finances, trying to get out of debt, plus all their church activities and all the volunteer activities. And they're pulling their hair out going, how do I juggle this all? Man, I once lived just like that until I learned Time Secrets. Time Secrets showed me how to be able to cut my hours from 100 hours a week that I was working down to 20 hours a week and tripled my income as a direct result with what I learned. Time Secrets also showed me how to get my priorities in order, which healed up my marriage. And I became a mother that I want now was proud of versus becoming the mother I didn't want to be. And so if you feel like your world is running around in all kinds of different circles, you can fix that. Call 888-757-8880. Again, 888-757-8880 for Time Secrets.
After plugging in the first steps to success, I've been able to pay off over $25,000 in debt. I've been able to live my life to the fullest and also excel in my career where I am sought out for different positions and opportunities.
I went from making no money to I made $13,000 extra using Dani's principles in that side business venture, and $104,000 that first year. I walked away from my military career after 8 years. It took me 5 years to pay off $292,000 in debt. Today, we're completely debt-free, and I've made a six-figure income every single year. The last several years, over $250,000 a year. Every single bit of it is because of what I learned at First Steps to Success. I would definitely recommend you get to the very next First Steps to Success event, no matter what it takes.
I was able to learn some great skills to pay off debt. I've paid off $38,000 in 27 months. My relationships are more genuine. They are more real. And my business, we've just now tripled our income in the business in just 2 short years.
My business is completely turned around. I'm now leading a big team in my business. I've been able to pay off some debt. I've found my spirituality again. That's probably the most important thing that I've gotten since attending is just building back up my relationship with God. And since then, everything else has been turning around.
Since attending First Steps Success and training with Dani Johnson, I've paid off in 11 months over $14,000 in debt. I've gone on 5 vacations and I've gotten 2 raises at my job. So I don't know where you're at all, but all I know is if you want a positive change in your life, I highly recommend you get to the next First Steps to Success register today.
We paid off over $35,000 in debt in 8 months, which I'm glad my wife did drag me to the event. And I've been very thankful for all the teachings that Dani and the community has given us.
Since plugging in, my husband and I are completely in love with each other. Our marriage has been completely restored. We've paid off almost $500,000 in debt. My life has completely changed. We have beautiful twin infants. We have enough money to do what we want, go where we want. We travel around the world, and I have hope and a reason to live again. So I would tell you to get to the next First Steps to Success. Get registered right now and join me there.
We're back. Here's Dani Johnson.
Could you imagine a boss saying to his employee, get out of my office. There she is trying to ask a question for a customer. The customer can hear this and he just says, get out of my office. How are you supposed to respond to that? Joining me right now is Jessica from Boston, Virginia. Yes, that was South Boston, Virginia. She's in this very situation. I could not imagine. Oh, I've had my husband say things like that to me, but not like this. I mean, this is foul. This is rude. And what, Jessica, did you just tell me that he has said out loud, and did he say this in front of a customer, that I've never wanted to hit a woman until I met you?
they said it in front of customers. They said it in front of employees.
And why are you still working there? This is mistreatment. This is misconduct. He does not deserve to have a person like you there, number one. Okay, now hold on one second. I just want to see how long this has been going on and how long you've allowed yourself to be treated like this, to the point, Jessica, that you have removed yourself from your positioning, that you said you were always the person whenever you saw someone else disrespect their boss or treat them bad or talk behind their back, you always said, hey, listen, this is your boss, like it or hate him, you have to respect them. So this boss has shaken you off of your core value of honor and give honor where honor is due. And this man's position is supposed to be honored and respected. So here he has disrespected you publicly. And as you confessed to me just a minute ago, that you said, you've even said leaving his office, that boss is such a jerk, which means you've disrespected him. This is a toxic relationship, girl. I have one question for you. Is there anybody else in your life you have this kind of relationship with?
Not currently, just one other coworker there, and this was my boss's best friend that actually is in charge when my boss is not there. Well, he would send others home early and try to come on to me. Keep in mind, he's a manager. Well, I wouldn't give in to it. After a while of this going on, I didn't want to get him in trouble.
No. Jessica, hold on a second. I need to know the answer to this question. How much are you making at this job?
Well, I'm making $9.50 an hour.
Jessica, go work at Popeyes. Go work at Popeyes. Go work at Taco Smell. Do not stay in this job for $9.50 an hour. Are you kidding me? You will not allow yourself to be treated like that anymore. Let me ask you a question. What if you had a daughter that was being treated like this in her job? What would you tell her?
I would tell her to get out, that she deserves better.
Then, girlfriend, it's time to look in the mirror and give yourself the same advice. Get out of there. If you are making $100,000 a year, I could see why you'd be struggling. But you ain't. You ain't. You do not allow yourself to be mistreated like this, disrespected like that, dishonored, embarrassed in front of other people, and a man that's coming on to you, ew! Ew! Yeah. You get out of there. Well, leave.
He didn't get fired.
I wonder why he didn't get fired for that. He ain't gonna get fired for that. Jessica, here's my final advice. Get out of there. Period. There's other jobs. There's other places to work. And you interview, by the way, the next job saying, hey, listen, I'm interviewing for the right company for me to sink my teeth into. I'm looking for the right opportunity that I will be with for the long haul that I can help this company grow. So I'd like to interview your staff to see how people are treated around here to make sure that this is the kind of quality place that I would like to make a long-term commitment with. I'd like to know, what is it like to work for the boss? What is it? What are the policies? How's the company morale here? You start interviewing these companies before you make another mistake of working for some yahoo that is biting the head off of his staff in front of a customer and allowing another staff member to, nearly commit a crime of sexual misconduct and then not get fired? Be done with it. And if you don't, you're being stupid, girl. Come on, you're smarter than this. Be done. Do not ever allow someone to treat you like that. Over and out. Ooh. Man, it just blows my mind that people could do things like that. Okay, we got Ron from Virginia. Welcome to the Dani Johnson Show. Hopefully it's not South Boston.
Hi, Dani. How are you?
Good. What can we do for you today?
South Boston.
Good.
Well, I'm from Watchville, actually.
Nice.
I have a home business, and I used to fly off the handle for the smallest things in the world, and I really always used to let it ruin my day.
Yes.
And it took me a while before I realized that that didn't solve anything. And that was after listening to a lot of your recordings and all, I realized that I was on the Joseph plan. I have a lot of things to learn, and, God just keeps giving me my lessons, and I have to pass
the test.
Those lessons before I can move on.
Yes.
So it's like, two steps forward, one step back.
Mm-hmm.
And, the other day I had a made a couple of sales on eBay and had to take losses on them because of mistakes I made.
Right.
Now, normally, it used to be I would have, you know, gotten really
upset.
Mad about that.
Yeah.
But now it's just like, well, here's another lesson I got to learn, you know.
Yeah.
So I just, you know, fulfilled my obligation, you know, for the sales. And
that's the way to go, Ron. It is absolutely.
Oh, that's
yes, that's all you can do. And that's such the right mindset about that. And you know what's so sad is that most people spend their time reacting about the lesson instead of just going, okay, you should have a file of lessons. In that case, it's a financial lesson, right? What did I learn from this situation so that moving forward, I don't make the same mistake again? And so as long as we're learning, we're growing, and we will get promoted up through the ranks to where we can handle more situations without freaking out. I used to be the same way, Ron. I'm telling you, I was the same exact way, just so explosive over one little thing. Like, for example, we had to take a hit on two California properties. We have a lot of property out in California. I spent my first 40 years of life out there. And such an interesting place, man. The market does what it does. We rather not manage. Well, there was a lot of mistakes that was made with this property in all reality. We made a lot of mistakes with the property. And we learned a lot of things with these two properties. But at the end of the day, and this is what's so awesome, is that I found myself not overreacting at all, but looking at, but hold on a second, we have an entire portfolio of land. We got 25 acres still in California, all of its own free and clear. And we can hold that forever. It's a bank. Our money is in that. There's equity in that land. And when the time comes right, there's over $500,000. Actually, there's much more than $500,000 of value in that land. So our overall prosperity or portfolio for California and the investments we made there is worth a lot of money. Just one property alone is worth over $400,000, then we only paid $70,000 for it. That's a lot.
Wow.
So we will wait. I don't care if we have to wait 20 years. We'll wait for that market to bounce back up and then bam, let that sucker hit the market. So overall, even though we lost on these two homes, we own 25 acres free and clear that we paid pennies for in comparison to what the value is. Like I said, the $70,000 that's worth over $400,000. Just hold. So you got the right attitude about that, Ron. I am so proud of you that this one sale or this one mistake is not the thing that makes or breaks us, ever. It's never one mistake that makes or breaks us. It is the overall picture that helps us to prosper. So you've got the right attitude there. Ron, thank you so much for sharing. That really helped somebody today. This is Dani Johnson. We'll continue after this.
Stay right here for more of the Dani Johnson Show.
I'm so blessed that I found what is in Grooming the Next Generation for Success. This is a book that is being taught in universities around the world. It's been noted as the best book on parenting that has ever been written. Crazy, if you ask me. But the point is that this thing gets results. Get your copy today, 888-757-8880. Again, that's 888-757-8880. Or go to DaniJohnson.com. That's DaniJohnson.com. Get your copy today. Hi, this is Dani Johnson. Let me ask you something. Do you dream about being more confident, more beautiful, more powerful? Are you that girl who never learned to wear makeup and now you're lost in a sea of YouTube videos? That busy mom who can't get enough sleep and just wants to feel pretty again? Or maybe you're that professional who wants a little more respect in the office. From the boardroom to the bedroom, celebrity makeup artist Extina Harmsworth from XMH Beauty will help you. Extina has a track record of making beauty easy on any budget. Her live classes, simple step-by-step professional beauty techniques, and insider secrets will set you apart from the crowd. So don't sit on your dream another minute. Learn from the best. Get your exclusive free gift from Extina today at xmhbeauty.com/Dani. That's xmhbeauty.com/D-A-N-I. I just heard this amazing story. One of our clients had written us, telling us that they had used job domination and unlimited success and has absolutely exploded their career. He said, Dani, I don't know where I'd be today without job domination and unlimited success. Listen, do you want more recognition from your coworkers? Do you want to be recommended to people all over the world? Do you want to be somebody that is highly sought after? Listen, if you're in a dead-end place where this gentleman found himself but then learned new strategies and changed everything in his work life, and obviously this has resulted in higher bonuses and pay raises, you're next. 888-757-8880. Get your copy of Job Domination right now. 888-757-8880. Again, 888-757-8880. Job Domination. That's what you need. It's time for you to dominate the job market and break through the rut that you're in.
Now, more of the Dani Johnson Show.
Of all things, a Canadian woman who her husband says, "You're the Hulk when you get mad. Don't make the Hulk mad." I love it. I don't love it. You know what I'm saying? I think it's hilarious because Canadians generally are more not as passionate as the rebellion Americans right below them. You know what I mean? We engage in every fight. They don't. But anyway, so we have Stephanie on the phone, and she realizes the price that her husband and her children and her coworkers are paying from her time bomb reactions that seem to happen. And she's looking for a solution. So I've asked her before we took this break to go back and look at what the triggers are. What are the things that by noon, is it by noon that that happens? Okay, so Stephanie, I want you to know there's a lot of different things that can trigger things like this. And is it around noon? Is it around the same time of day every day that this happens?
Usually, yep.
Okay, honey.
Lunchtime.
Oh, honey, you're hangry. Honey, you're hangry. So that means that mom needs a 10:30 snack. And it needs to be a healthy snack that feeds your body because you're hangry. You know what hangry is, right? You're hungry. And here's what happens when you're a mom, baby. Mm-hmm. Here's what happens is that when you're a mom, who eats first?
My baby.
Exactly. And they're babies. So they're hangry. What do babies do when they're hungry? They're angry. Right?
Yep.
So you literally could just have a snack and let that snack, okay, and mind you, there's also a time for kids to have a nap or to have their own quiet time. These are the things I did when my kids were little, by the way, because I would notice it's like, I'm starving too, right? I've been up since 6, right? It's now noon, and they've had a couple of snacks in between, but I didn't eat. And then they had a nap in between, and I didn't, right? Because I got laundry to do. I got to get dinner ready, right? You got all these things going. And so you cannot ever underestimate the value of rest and food. A good, healthy snack. And let it be that when you have that snack at 10:30 in the morning or whenever, that you use that time to say, "Thank you, Lord, for the presence of your Holy Spirit." That's what you need, Stephanie. You need food and the Holy Spirit. And even if it is, okay, you just dwell on that right there. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for your patience. Thank you for your peace. You see, the fruit of the Holy Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, gentleness, kindness, self-control. You need food. And you need to feed on the Holy Spirit as well. Also, Stephanie, water.
Mm-hmm.
Not coffee, not soda, not tea, not juice. All of these things jack with your emotions. They jack with your body. They jolt your body with a sugar rush or a caffeine rush, which also makes you angry. When you first get it and when you come off of it. So get rid of that. Or at least have less and add water. Water with you throughout the day. Snacks every 2.5 hours. Eat something. That is going to make you more peaceful around the kids and give you more patience, as well as feed on the Holy Spirit and get plenty of rest. I don't know what you're doing, but if you ain't getting 8 minimum hours of sleep, they say if you do 9 hours of sleep, you lose 3 to 4 pounds in that one night. Get on the scale at night, sleep 9 hours, get on the scale in the morning. You're 3 to 4 pounds lighter. Your body has to rest. It has to recover. Your emotions need to unplug. Take care of mommy. And mommy, spend time with the Holy Spirit in the shower, asking the Lord to have his Holy Spirit fall upon you in the shower. Listen to peaceful music. These things will help you to really no longer have the Hulk manifest as much as it did before, and step by step, day by day, you're going to get better and better and better. You got to grow in love with peace, my sister. And once you do, you won't let go of it. It ain't worth it. Gosh, Stephanie, thank you so much for your call. This was so helpful. Helpful as a reminder for me and helpful for anybody that was listening. I've got Sunshine from Atlanta. What a great name. I want that name. Good morning, Sunshine. That's such a great name. Hi. What can we do for you today?
I had commented to let you know before. San Antonio, spiritual equipping. It was all fun and games and fine and good, and you were out there and you were telling the story about Nicaragua, and you were telling how you got convicted to love Hans like you love him. And my thought was, oh, that's so wonderful for them. That's so great. And isn't that lovely that she has that relationship with God? And I would love to have a relationship like that as well. It's not that I don't have a spiritual walk. I just didn't feel it was maybe as strong.
Meaning that you didn't love Jesus. Yeah, no.
No, and then I got the, you know, not even a minute had passed of, duh, that's for you. And I was in tears.
Wow.
My husband and I had just had an argument on the phone coming into that session.
Wow.
Right before it. And I was so mad, and I was in the right, and I was... Yeah.
And the Lord had a message for you that night.
And I was angry. I was mad. I was at a 10. And I was trying not to be. And then I got that. And I got convicted of a lot of other things that weekend as well. Mm. To say my life has changed since San Antonio is the understatement of the century.
Wow.
But I have found for me personally, because this is something I've been actively working on since I came back, because, you know, when you get the duh, that's for you, you kind of tend to sit up and listen if you're smart.
Mm-hmm.
And I have to bite my tongue. I'm very much a sapphire. I'm very much the first thing that pops into my head.
Yeah, pops right out of your mouth. Yep.
And so biting my tongue a bit more has helped.
And that's self-control. That's self-control, Sunshine. And self-control is always going to bear really good fruit. It will always bear good fruit. Nothing bad will ever come from exercising that fruit of the Spirit of self-control. And you also need the Spirit in you in order to have self-control. If we have the Holy Spirit in us, we naturally have self-control. That doesn't mean that we can choose not to use it every day, too. So I'm so proud of you that you are mindful of this, that you're hearing this, that you're working on it. So many people don't do that. All right, this is Dani Johnson. Thanks so much for joining me today. I've thoroughly enjoyed my time working with you, and I'm so sorry we've got Cindy. We got two Cindys, one from Idaho and one from Georgia on the line. We were not able to get to those calls. We so appreciate your comments that you left us on Facebook as well. So, hey, if you enjoyed today's show, it helped you, share it with somebody else because someone else is in need of this kind of stuff. We'll talk to you tomorrow where we will challenge you to live a life much better than the one you're living today. You got another day tomorrow. God bless you. Bye-bye.
You've been listening to The Dani Johnson Show. It's our belief that you can live a better, healthier, happier life. All you need is a little encouragement. Get that and more on the next Dani Johnson Show.
Hi, welcome to the Dani Johnson YouTube channel. We're super excited to have you here. And every single week, we're going to make sure that you get awesome videos for your business, career, making more money, saving money, annihilating your debt, as well as helping you to handle those really tough problems that you have with people at home, as well as at work, and taking those really good relationships you already have and causing them to flourish and grow. All you have to do is click that subscribe button right down here Click that and you'll be subscribed to an amazing community of people, as well as some great videos that will help to improve your life. Thanks so much for being here. Subscribe now would be good. Just click it. I know you can see it. It's somewhere down here. Okay, talk to you later. Bye.